Okay, we've come to the last presentation.
Also wir sind bei dem letzten Vortrag angekommen.
And the notes have, again, I've put in the live streams.
Und die Notizen sind wieder in den Livestream zu haben.
Now, obviously, there's much more that I would like to do with the book of Daniel and Revelation.
Und natürlich gibt es viel mehr, was ich mit den Büchern von Daniel und der Offenbarung tun würde oder könnte.
But the purpose of this was to show how the structure is repeating over and over, and we're seeing the same things.
Aber der Zweck von diese Vorträge ist, dass wir den Struktur sehen können, wie es sich mal nach mal sich wiederholt.
And I don't know about yourselves, but for me, I have many questions I want answered now from my studies from this.
Und ich weiß nicht, wie es ihr geht, aber ich habe jetzt viele Fragen, die aufgekommen sind, die ich Antworten suche nach diesem Studium, die ich gemacht habe.
But nonetheless, it's always the same. Whenever you learn new things from the Bible, you realize you know nothing at all.
Aber das ist immer dasselbe. Wenn auch immer du Neues aus der Bibel lernst, dann merkst du, dass du eigentlich gar nichts weißt.
Okay, so anyway, let's begin. Daniel chapter 8 and verse 1.
So, lasst uns anfangen. Daniel 8, Vers 1.
Now, Daniel 7 and Daniel 8, they're very much related, right?
Daniel 7 und Daniel 8, die sind miteinander sehr verwandt.
And it says in verse 1 here,
Vers 1 sagt es,
in the third year of the reign of King Belshazzar, a vision appeared unto me, even unto me, Daniel, after that which appeared to me at the first. So, which year of Belshazzar?
So, welches Jahr von Belshazzar?
The third.
Der dritte.
And Daniel 7?
Und Daniel 7?
The first.
Der erste.
So all the way through, we've been talking about this, how this first year and this third year, they're very much linked together.
So der ganze Weg hindurch haben wir zu sehen bekommen, dass diese erste und dritte Jahr sind miteinander verknüpft.
How the first year of Cyrus and the third year of Cyrus are also linked together.
Wie der erste Jahr Kyros und der dritte Jahr Kyros sind auch miteinander verbunden.
Okay, the first year of Jehoiakim, the third year of Jehoiakim are also mixed together.
Der erste Jahr von Joachim und der dritte Jahr von Joachim sind auch miteinander vermengt.
Okay, and so and these two points that we're talking about here are illustrated by these two entities right here.
Und diese zwei Punkte, über denen wir hier sprechen, die werden dargestellt durch diese zwei Entitäten hier.
And what I mean by that is that, for instance, there we have here, forget that one. Let's take the 4-7 times. For instance.
Das bedeutet zum Beispiel, lass uns die 4-7 Zeiten nehmen.
They're marked by Manasseh, Cyrus, Darius and Artaxerxes, right?
Sie werden markiert durch Manasseh, Kyros, Darius und Artaxerxes.
So you have Manasseh. Manasseh, Jehoiakim, Jehoiachin and Zedekiah.
So Manasseh, Jehoiakim, Jehoiachin and Zedekiah.
See, you have to keep me right, right? I've got so many things in my head. Right? So you would have Manasseh, Jehoiakim, Jehoiachin, Zedekiah. It's these last four kings.
So Manasseh, Jehoiakim, Jehoiachin, Zedekiah.
Okay,
and the four letzten sieben Zeiten.
We were shown how in the classes when we go through the week, these two waymarks are inseparably linked.
Und die Klassen, die wir hindurchgegangen sind, diese zwei Wegmarken sind unzertrennlich miteinander verbunden.
Okay, and specifically, those 4-7 times are a parallel to the four abominations.
Right? Ganz besonders diese 4-7 Zeiten sind parallel mit den vier Gräueln.
Right, and the four abominations are the four parts of the statue.
Und diese vier Gräueln sind die vier Teile der Statue.
And what's the first two parts of the statue?
Was sind die ersten zwei Teilen der Statue?
Babylon, Medo-Persia. Right?
Babylon und Medo-Persia.
The lion and the bear. Right?
Der Löwe und der Bär.
Okay, so that's how I come to that conclusion.
Right? So bin ich zu diesem Zusammenschluss gekommen.
Okay, so this these two points, there's something really deep about it that the Lord wants us to understand.
Right? So diese Punkte, diese zwei Punkte, es gibt was sehr Tiefes darin, der der Herr möchte, dass wir verstehen.
But specifically here in Daniel 8 in verse 1,
aber ganz besonders hier in Daniel 8 Vers 1,
it says that this vision is the same vision as he saw at the first in Daniel chapter 7.
Es sagt, dass diese Vision ist derselbe Vision, die er zuerst gesehen hat in Daniel 7.
Because that's Daniel's first vision he sees in Daniel 7.
Right? Daniel 7, das ist eben Daniels erste Vision.
But the differences between them is that, as we saw in Daniel 7, it's talking about the political kingdoms. Here it's talking about false religious powers. Right?
Aber der Unterschied ist, wie wir gesehen haben in Daniel 7, es spricht über politische Mächte, hier in Daniel 8 falsche religiöse Kräfte.
Why is it talking about false religions in Daniel 8?
Daniel 8, warum spricht es über falsche religiöse Mächte? Not pure.
What? Brother Christian, I'm going to ask you directly. Why are those false religions in Daniel 8?
So, warum sind diese falsche Religionen in Daniel 8?
What makes them religious? The symbols.
Was macht sie religiös, diese Symbole?
What symbols do we have in Daniel 8? The very first two we see.
Welche Symbole haben wir in Daniel 8? Die ersten zwei.
Ram and a goat. And a goat, right? So why are those religious? Because we find them in the sanctuary, right?
Wir finden sie im Heiligtum.
The sanctuary had these, they would take a goat or a lamb and use them for sacrifices, right?
Und in das Heiligtum, die werden einen Ziegenbock oder ein Lamm und die werden sie benutzen zum Opfergabe.
But any sacrifices that were taken in there, how did they have to be?
Aber die Opfergaben, die da ins Heiligtum hineingebracht worden sind, wie mussten sie denn sein?
Okay, so what's wrong? What's wrong with the ram?
Sie mussten ohne Makel sein. Also was ist falsch mit der Widder?
One horn's bigger than the other, right?
Ein Horn ist größer als der andere.
What about the goat?
Was ist mit der Ziegenbock?
It should have two horns, but it's got one big one and then four little ones, right?
Es sollte zwei Hörner sein, aber es hat ein großer und vier kleine.
So Christ would never accept them, right?
So Christus würde sie als Opfergaben nie akzeptieren.
So they represent false religious symbols.
Right? Die stellen falsche religiöse Symbole dar.
So the kingdoms are manifested in Daniel 2.
So die Königreiche, die werden in Daniel 2 dargestellt.
Daniel 7 is the political aspect of that kingdom.
Daniel 7 ist die politische Aspekt dieses Königreichen.
In Daniel 8 the religious aspect of that kingdom.
Und in Daniel 8 die religiöse Aspekte.
Okay, so when you put them both together, what do you have?
So wenn du beide zusammentust, was hast du?
Church and state, right?
Staat und Kirche.
Okay, so this is all it's shown us here, right? So in verse 2,
Vers 2,
and I saw in a vision, and it came to pass when I saw that I was at Shushan in the palace, which is in the province of Elam, and I saw in a vision, and I was by the river of Ulia. So where is Daniel here?
So wo ist Daniel hier?
Says he's in Shushan the palace.
Sagt, dass er in Shushan der Palast ist.
Okay, now there's three places in the Bible where Shushan the palace is marked.
Es gibt drei Plätze in der Bibel, wo Shushan der Palast markiert ist.
Here with Nehemiah and also in the book of Esther.
So right? Hier in der Buch von Nehemia und auch im Buch Esther.
Okay, and I know that Brother Lawrence has been going through the book of Nehemiah.
Right? Ich weiß, dass Bruder Lorenz hat den Buch Nehemia dargelegt.
So let's look in Esther chapter 1.
So lasst uns in das Buch Esther, Kapitel 1, gucken.
Verse 1.
Esther 1 und Vers 1.
It says, now it came to pass in the days of Ahasuerus, this is Ahasuerus, which reigned from India even unto Ethiopia over 127 provinces, that in those days when the king Ahasuerus sat on the throne of his kingdom, which was in Shushan the palace. Right? Now these symbols are specifically designed to link these things together, right?
Diese Symbole, die sind bedacht, einander miteinander zu verknüpfen.
So when you understand all the prophets are speaking about the same thing, then you just bring all the Shushan together and you're at the same point in time, right?
So wenn wir verstehen, dass alle Propheten über dasselbe am Ende der Welt sprechen, man bringt nur alle Schuhschauen der Paläste zusammen und wir wissen, dass da sprechen wir über denselben Zeitpunkt.
So, let's read about Esther right now to find out what it's speaking about.
So, lasst uns über Esther lesen, um so herauszufinden, worüber es spricht.
Okay, this quote from Prophets and Kings.
Erste Zitat von Propheten und Könige.
The trying experiences that came to God's people in the days of Esther were not peculiar to that age alone. The Revelator. Right, so where's it taking us to?
So, der Offenbarer. Wo bringt uns das hin?
Revelation. Which is?
Offenbarung.
The revelation of?
Der Offenbarung von?
Daniel.
Der Offenbarung von Daniel.
Right, the revelation is the revelation of the book of Daniel, right?
Der Offenbarung ist der Offenbarung der Buch Daniel.
Okay, so the Revelator, looking down the ages to the close of time, has declared, the dragon was wroth with the woman and went to make war with the remnant of her seed, which keep the commandments of God and of the testimony of Jesus Christ. Some who today are living on earth will see these words fulfilled. The same spirit that in ages past led men to persecute the true church will in the future lead to the pursuance of a similar course towards those who maintain their loyalty to God. Even now, preparations are being made for this last great conflict. The decree that will finally go forth against the remnant people of God will be very similar to that issued by Ahasuerus against the Jews. Today the enemies of the true church see in the little company keeping the Sabbath commandment a Mordecai at the gate. The reverence of God's people for his law is a constant rebuke to those who have cast off the fear of the Lord and are trampling on his Sabbath. Now, we've gone to so many books over the last few days, just in relation to the book of Daniel.
Right. Wir sind so viele Bücher in den letzten Tagen gegangen, die nur Bezug auf den Buch Daniels nehmen.
And they're all relating to the Sunday law. Right?
Sie beziehen sich alle auf das Sonntagsgesetz.
Okay, and this is what the whole Bible is an illustration of the Sunday law at the end of the world.
Und die ganze Bibel ist eine Darstellung der Sonntagsgesetz am Ende der Welt.
Okay, so when Seventh-day Adventists say that you can't find a Sunday law in the Bible, I mean, that's a terrible, terrible darkness, right?
Also, wenn Siebentags-Adventisten von sich geben, dass sie in der Bibel kein Sonntagsgesetz finden, das ist eine schreckliche Finsternis, in dem sie sich befinden.
Okay, anyway, let's go back to Daniel 8 and verse 3.
Daniel 8 and verse 3.
So we can see the book of Esther, reference in Shushan the palace, is about the Sunday law, and we know every chapter we've gone through so far in Daniel is about the Sunday law, right?
So wir können sehen, im Buch Esther, Shushan, der Palast, spricht über das Sonntagsgesetzkrise und wir wissen, dass jeder Kapitel von das Buch Daniels, die wir bisher hindurchgegangen sind, weist auf das Sonntagsgesetz.
And Daniel 8 is the same vision as Daniel 7.
Und Daniel 8 ist derselbe Vision wie Daniel 7.
So verse 3.
So Vers 3 jetzt.
Then I lifted up mine eyes and saw, and behold, there stood before the river a ram, which had two horns, and the two horns were high, but one was higher than the other, and the higher came up last. Okay, if the Bible's, if all the prophets are speaking about the same thing, who is this right here?
So, wenn alle Propheten sprechen über dasselbe, wer ist das hier, diese Widder?
Yes, the United States. Why?
Es ist der USA. Warum wohl?
Two horns. Because it's got two horns, yes. Right? It's this two-horned beast.
Zwei Hörner hat. Es ist ein zweihörniger Tier.
And specifically, why? What's with the horns?
Und ganz besonders, warum? Was ist mit den Hörnern?
Yeah, which one's bigger than the other one?
So, welche ist höher als das andere?
The one that comes up last, right?
Das, was zuletzt höher gekommen ist.
So when United States began, which horn was in control?
So als der USA aufgekommen ist, welche Horn hatte die Kontrolle?
Republicanism, right?
Republikanische.
And so this one that comes up last is the church horn is now in control, right?
So diese Horn, der zuletzt aufkommt, ist die Gemeinde, es ist die religiöse.
So when the church is in control of the state, that causes trouble, right?
Also wenn die Gemeinde die Kontrolle über den Staat hat, dann heißt das Trübsal.
We just see this in Revelation 13.
Und wir können das in Offenbarung 13 erkennen.
Verse 11.
Vers 11 und 12.
And I beheld another beast coming up out of the earth. He had two horns like a lamb, and he spake as a dragon. And he exerciseth all the power of the first beast before him, and causeth the earth and them which dwell therein to worship the first beast whose deadly wound was healed. Right? So when the deadly wound's healed, it marks the point where that woman is now sitting back on those 10 kings that she got knocked off of in 1798.
So wenn der tödliche Wunde geheilt ist, es markiert die Frau, die sitzt wieder auf diesen 10 Könige, von dem sie niedergestoßen war in 1798.
Now, in Daniel 8, it says Daniel saw a ram which had two horns, right?
Daniel 8, es sagt, dass Daniel sah einen Widder, der zwei Hörner hat.
And specifically in this next quote,
und ganz besonders in diesem nächsten Zitat,
it uses the same expression. It says, I saw that the two-horned beast had a dragon's mouth.
Benutzt derselbe Ausdrucksweise.
And that his power was in his head, and that the decree would go out of his mouth. Right? So, the United States, very clearly here, is this two-horned beast. It's the one that makes the Sunday law. Right?
So, den USA ist hier klar zu sehen, diese zweihörnige Tier, der das Sonntagsgesetz erlässt.
In verse 4,
und wieder Daniel 8, Vers 4,
it says, I saw the ram pushing westward and northward and southward, so that no beast might stand before him, neither was there any that could deliver out of his hand, but he did according to his will and became great. So, what do we see him doing?
So, was sehen wir, dass er hier tut?
He's pushing in three directions, right?
So, er stößt in drei Richtungen.
Now, when we're talking about Goliath, Goliath goes from here all the way to here, right?
Wenn wir sprechen über Goliath, er geht den ganzen Weg von hier bis da.
Okay? And he gets smacked at the end, right?
Und er wird erschlagen am Ende.
Okay? And when we come down to this level, right?
Wenn wir hier auf diesen Fraktal kommen,
it's just the same. We have the whoever power is coming up here, they go all the way to the end.
So, welchen Macht hier aufkommt, die gehen den ganzen Weg bis zur Ende.
And we know this because this two-horned power comes up here. How long does it reign for?
Denn wir wissen, dass diese zweihörnige Macht hier heraufkommt und wie lange regiert es?
For 3.5 years.
So, for 3.5 Jahren bis zur Ende.
And that's where he's going to get the punishment, right?
Da erhält er die Strafe.
Okay. So I want to suggest when it's pushing westward, northward and southward, it's just a representation of this. At least that's what I'm going on at the moment. I'm open to maybe understand those things better.
But also wenn es sagt, dass er steht Westen, Norden und Süden, dann ich meine, dass es nur diese drei Punkte hier markiert. Also zumindest das ist meine bis jetzige Verständnis.
Okay.
Aber daran bleibe ich offen.
It's marking this time period where it's reigning, right?
Also es markiert diese Zeitperiode, wo es in der Regentschaft ist.
So, what did Daniel see? He saw a ram, right?
Was sagt Daniel? Was sah er? Ein Widder.
And the ram had two horns.
Und dieser Widder hat zwei Hörner.
So, what he sees is the same thing, right?
So das, was Daniel sieht, ist dasselbe.
Okay. And where are we? Where are we? Okay, so if we go down to Daniel 8 and verse 5.
So yes, verse 5.
And as I was considering, behold, a he-goat came from the west on the face of the whole earth, and touched not the ground, and the he-goat had a notable horn between his eyes. And he came to the ram that had two horns, which had been standing before the river, and ran into him in the fury of his power. And I saw him come close unto the ram, and he was moved with choler against him, and smote the ram, and brake his two horns. And there was no power in the ram to stand before him, but he cast him down to the ground, and stamped upon him, and there was none that could deliver the ram out of his hand. Now I want to suggest that this goat here, right?
Ich möchte vorschlagen, dass dieser Ziegenbock hier,
which has this
goat,
has this horn is a power that comes against this northern power.
So dieser Ziegenbock hier, das ist ein Macht, der gegen diesen Nordmacht kommt.
Right at the end here.
Gerade am Ende hier.
Because when you're standing here, what is it you're predicting?
Denn wenn du hier stehst, was ist es, was du verheißt?
Yes, you're predicting the fall of the north, right?
Du vorhersagst das Sturz des Nordens.
And also you're telling them that it's the south that's going to bring it about, right?
Natürlich sagst du, dass es den Süden, die diesen Sturz hervorbringen wird.
And the east wind.
Und das Ostwind,
right? So whenever you're standing at this point, you're making a prediction about the fall of the woman.
So wenn immer du stehst an diesem Punkt, du machst eine Vorhersage über den Sturz der Frau,
right? So here you have the north, and this power right here, the south, is one of the, is part of the power that's responsible for bringing the north down.
So hier haben wir den Norden und hier den Süden. Das ist eine Teil des Machtes, die verantwortlich sind, den Norden zu Stürze zu bringen.
Okay, now it says here in this last verse, it says there was none that could deliver the ram out of his hand. Why not?
7, es sagt, niemand konnte den Widder aus seinem Gewalt retten. Und wieso nicht?
Why not?
Wieso?
Because it's prophecy.
Yes, because God's word will fulfill exactly as he says, right?
Das ist Prophetie. Gottes Wort wird sich erfüllen, genauso wie es sagt.
So, Daniel 11 and verse 45.
So, jetzt Daniel 11, Vers 45.
It says, and he shall plant the tabernacles of his palace between the seas and the glorious holy mountain. Yet he shall come to his end, and none shall help him, right? So what did it say in Daniel 8, 7?
So was sagte es in Daniel 8, 7?
None can deliver out of his hand, right?
Niemand kann ihm aus seiner Gewalt retten.
And here in Daniel 11, 45, it says, none shall help him. Same words,
Daniel
right?
Hier in Daniel 11, 45, es sagt, niemand wird ihm helfen. Selbe Worte.
Okay, so now let's go to Revelation 17.
Jetzt gehen wir zu Offenbarung 17, Verse 12 und 13.
And we'll see the same illustration, because whatever we see in Daniel, we should also see in the book of Revelation.
Und wir werden derselbe Darstellung sehen, denn das, was wir in das Buch Daniel erkennen, sollten wir auch in das Buch Offenbarung zu sehen bekommen.
Okay, it says, verse 12.
Vers 12.
The 10 horns which thou sawest are 10 kings, which have received no kingdom as yet, but receive power as kings 1 hour with the beast. These have one mind and shall give their power and strength unto the beast. These shall make war with the Lamb, and the Lamb shall overcome them, for he is Lord of lords, King of kings, and they that are with him are called and chosen and faithful. Right? So, the 10 kings, they are going to, it says, these have one mind, they give their strength and power unto the beast.
Right, so diese 10 Königen, die sind einmutigen Sinne und sie geben ihre Macht und Herrschaft dem Tier.
So at the beginning of the Sunday law, you have the 10 kings and the woman, right?
So am Anfang des Sonntagsgesetzes gibt es die 10 Könige und die Frau.
And that's what's represented in these symbols here, right?
Das ist, was hier in diesen Symbolen dargestellt ist.
Right?
Amen.
King is basically the king of the north, right?
Es ist im Grunde der König des Nordens.
Okay, so they're going to receive this power and they're going to stay with the beast for 1 hour.
Sie right? werden diese Macht erhalten und sie werden mit diesem Tier für eine Stunde beibleiben.
Okay, and if we go to, in fact, we've looked at this already, but let's go there again. At Psalm 83.
So Psalm 83, schauen wir uns das nochmal an.
It's good that we look at these things over and over, and that way we don't forget them.
Es ist gut, dass wir diese Sachen wiederholen, so das sorgt dafür, dass wir sie nicht vergessen.
Verse 1.
Vers 1.
And the 10 horns which thou sawest are 10 kings which have received no kingdom as yet. Oh, excuse me, sorry, Psalm 83.
Psalm 83. Vers 1.
Keep not thou silence, O God, hold not thy peace, and be not still, O God. For lo, thine enemies make a tumult, and they that hate thee have lifted up their head. They have taken crafty counsel against thy people, and consulted against thy hidden ones. They have said, come and let us cut them off from being a nation, that the name of Israel may no more be in remembrance. For they have consulted together with one consent, they are confederated against thee. The tabernacles of Edom and the Ishmaelites of Moab, of the Hagarines, of Gebal, Ammon, Amalek, Philistines, with the inhabitants of Tyre and Assur also. 10 nations. Right?
10 nations.
So these 10 kings lift up their head, right?
So these 10 Könige, die erheben das Haupt.
And if you just look at this portion of this quote underneath,
und wenn wir diesen Teil, diesen Zitates hier direkt darunter lesen,
the world is filled with storm and war and variance. What's the world filled with?
Womit ist der Welt gefüllt?
Storm and war and variance.
Sturm und Krieg und Entzweiung.
Yet under one head, the people power, the people will unite to oppose God in the person of his witnesses. So, she's the head, right? She's sitting on these kingdoms, right?
So, sie ist der Haupt. Sie sitzt hier auf diesen Königreichen.
Because she's controlling their minds.
Weil sie kontrolliert deren Verstände.
Okay. So, go to Revelation 13 again.
Geht zu Offenbarung 13.
Vers 11. And I beheld another beast coming up out of the earth, and he had two horns like a lamb, and he spake as a dragon. And he exerciseth all the power of the first beast before him, and causeth the earth and them which dwell therein to worship the first beast, whose deadly wound was healed. So when this two-horned beast comes, he's going to cause the whole earth to worship the first beast, the papacy, whose deadly wound is now healed. Right?
Das zweihornige Tier, wenn es kommt, es wird die ganze Welt dafür sorgen, dass es der erste Tier, dessen tödliche Wunde geheilt worden ist, anbetet.
And he doeth great wonders, so that he maketh fire come down from heaven on the side of men. And this is this bear with these spirits coming out of his mouth. Right?
Diesen Wundertaten, das ist dieser Bär mit diesen Geistern, die aus seinem Maul hervorkommen.
Sister White says it's miracles, right?
And White sagt, das sind Wundertaten.
And deceiveth them that dwell on the earth by the means of those miracles which he had power to do in the sight of the beast, saying to them that dwell on the earth that they should make an image to the beast which had the wound by a sword and did live. So, what is this power doing?
So, was tut diesen Macht hier?
It's deceiving the whole earth.
Es right? Verführt die gesamten Erde.
Okay, now go to Revelation 16.
Jetzt gehen wir zur Offenbarung 16.
We just confirm this point we were talking about earlier.
Und wir werden diesen Punkt, den wir vorher gesprochen haben, bestätigen.
And I saw three unclean spirits like frogs come out of the mouth of the dragon, out of the mouth of the beast, and out of the mouth of the false prophet. For they are the spirit of devils working miracles, which go forth unto the kings of the earth and the whole world. So who do they go to?
So zu wem gehen sie?
Yes, but it's specific symbols. They go to the kings of the earth, right?
Also, das ist ganz bestimmte Symbolen. Die gehen zum Könige der Erde.
Now, we've already established that the 10 kings are already controlled by the woman, right?
Wir haben bereits etabliert, dass die 10 Könige sind bereits unter die Kontrolle der Frau.
But it says that this symbol now goes to deceive the kings of the earth.
Aber es sagt, dass dieses Symbol geht, um die Könige der Erde zu verführen.
Because it's teaching us that there's two groups of kings, right?
Das lehrt uns, es gibt zwei Gruppen von Königen.
The north and the south.
Das Norden und den Süden.
Okay. And then it says, Revelation 17 and verse 15.
Offenbarung 17, Vers 15.
And he saith unto me, the waters which thou sawest where the horse sitteth are peoples and multitudes of nations and tongues. Right? So she's going to sit over the whole world.
So sie werde über den gesamten Welt sitzen.
But now let's look at what happens.
Aber jetzt schauen wir an, was geschieht.
From Desire of Ages 778.
Von das Leben Jesu 778.
The priest gave directions for securing the sepulchre. Uh, is this the same quote we read earlier, right?
Yes, it was, yes.
Yes.
Second part of the quote we didn't read earlier.
We didn't?
No. Why do the heathen rage and people imagine of being...
We read that also.
I don't know, I couldn't remember putting that in there and that set of notes. Doesn't matter. Okay, no problem. But just remind us that I think that's maybe an accident that's in there.
I think so.
Yeah, I mean, that shouldn't be there. I mean, because it's under a wrong heading. I've probably put that there by pure by accident. So just go past that. Just go past that quote in Psalm 2 and go down to Revelation 17.
So gehen wir an diesem Zitat und das, was im Psalm 2 geschrieben ist, vorbei und wir kommen hinunter zu Offenbarung 17, beginnen Vers 16.
It says, and the 10 horns which thou sawest upon the beast, these shall hate the whore, and shall make her desolate and naked, and shall eat her flesh, and burn her with fire. For God hath put in their hearts to fulfil his will, and to agree and give their kingdom unto the beast, until the words of God shall be fulfilled. So it's talking about the 10 kings that are on this dragon, right, this symbol.
So it spricht über die 10 Könige, die auf diesem Drache ist, diesen Symbol.
Right, the ones that agree to give their kingdom.
Diejenigen, die übereinstimmen, deren Königreich zu geben,
are now going to eat our flesh and burn her with fire.
Die werden jetzt ihren Fleisch essen und sie mit Feuer verbrennen.
Okay.
Ihre Fleisch essen.
But if you go to Revelation 18,
aber wenn du zur Offenbarung 18 jetzt gehst,
Vers 9, it says, and the kings of the earth who have committed fornication and lived deliciously with her shall bewail her and lament for her when they shall see the smoke of her burning, standing afar off for the fear of her torment, saying, alas, alas, that great city Babylon, that mighty city, for in 1 hour is thy judgment come, and the merchants of the earth shall weep and mourn over her. So who's weeping and mourning over her here?
So wer heult und klagt über sie hier?
The kings and the merchants, right?
Also die Könige und die Seeleute oder Handelsleute.
How many kings is there?
Wie viele Könige gibt es?
10, right?
10.
Now, I've not put it in the notes, but you can just go there quickly. Go to Ezekiel 27.
Also ich habe das nicht in den Notizen getan, aber wir können da schnell hingehen. Ezekiel 27.
In Vers 1.
Vers 1.
The word of the Lord came again unto me, saying, now thou son of man, take up a lamentation for Tyrus, and say unto Tyrus, O thou that art situate at the entry of the sea, which are a merchant of the people, for many isles, thus saith the Lord God, O Tyrus, thou hast said, I am perfect of beauty. Who says that?
Wer sagt das?
I'm a queen and I shall see no sorrow, right?
The Papst told me, sitze wie eine Königin und werde kein Trauer sehen.
Okay, it's basically the same language. Sister White says that Tyre represents the papacy.
Es ist derselbe Sprache. Ellen White sagt, dass Tyrus stellt den Papsttum dar.
So, this is a prophecy against the papacy. Right?
Das hier ist eine Prophezeiung gegen der Papsttum.
And I know that we've looked at this before, but from verses 12 all the way down to verses 23, there's 10 groups of merchants.
Und ich weiß, dass wir das vorher angeschaut haben. Also von Vers 12 bis 23 können wir 10 verschiedene Gruppen von Handelsleute erkennen.
Okay. Now, if you just go to verse 26.
Und Vers 26.
It says, thy rowers have brought thee into great waters. The east wind hath broken thee in the midst of the seas. Who breaks Tyre here?
So wer ist es, der Tyros hier bricht?
The east wind.
The Ostwind.
And it says, thy riches and thy fares, thy merchandise, thy mariners and thy pilots, thy caulkers and the occupiers of thy merchandise, and all the men of war that are in thee, and all the company which is in the midst of thee, shall fall into the midst of the seas in the day of thy ruin. The suburbs shall shake at the sound of the cry of thy pilots, And all that handle the oar, the mariners and all the pilots of the sea, shall come down from their ships, and shall stand upon the land, and shall cause their voice to be heard against thee, and shall cry bitterly, and shall cast up dust upon their heads, and they shall wallow themselves in the ashes, and they shall make themselves utterly bald for thee, and gird them with sackcloth, and shall weep for thee with bitterness of heart and bitter wailing. And in their wailing they shall take up a lamentation for thee, and lament over thee, saying, what city is like unto Babylon? Right?
So, welche Stadt ist wie Babylon? Vers 32.
So it says Tyre, right?
Nein, es sagt Tyrus.
But this is what they say in Revelation 18. What city is like unto Babylon?
Aber das ist das, was sie in Offenbarung 18 sehen. Welche Stadt ist wie Babylon?
Like the destroyed in the midst of the sea. When thy wares went forth out of the seas, thou filledst many people, thou did enrich the kings of the earth. Who did it enrich?
So, wer hat's bereichert?
The kings of the earth.
Die Könige der Erde.
With the multitude of thy riches and of thy merchandise, in the time when thou shalt be broken by the seas. Who's breaking them?
So, wer bricht sie?
The seas.
In Seen.
And according to Revelation 17, what is the seas?
Und gemäß Offenbarung 17, was ist die Seen?
Nations.
Right? Nationen.
So there's two things that's breaking her here, right?
So, gibt's zwei Sachen, die sie hier bricht.
The east wind.
Das Ostwind.
And the nation.
Und die Nation.
Right? So, when you go back to Revelation 17.
So, wenn wir zurück hier zur Offenbarung 17 gehen.
In verse 16.
Vers 16.
And the ten horns which thou sawest upon the beast, these shall hate the whore, shall make her desolate and naked, and shall eat her flesh and burn her with fire. It's not the same kings, right?
Sind nicht dieselben Könige.
Because the kings that we're reading about are weeping and wailing that they've been brought down, right?
Denn diese Könige, über denen wir sprechen, die heulen und wehklagen, dass sie niedergebracht worden ist.
Okay. So, hence you have this beast right here, this Greek power, right?
Deswegen haben wir diese Tier hier, diese griechische Macht.
Now, if you look at this war at the moment between the north and the south,
so wenn wir gerade diesen Krieg zwischen Norden und Süden anschauen,
or in other words, between the Republicans and the Democrats,
oder anders gesagt, diesen Krieg zwischen den Republikanern und den Demokraten,
What is it at the moment that the Democrats are basically so happy about?
So, worüber feiern sich die Demokraten gerade?
They're saying it over and over again.
Sie sagen es wieder und wieder und wieder.
Democracy is going to be brought back into play.
So, Demokratie wird wieder ins Spiel gebracht.
Just look at the newspapers. Watch what they're saying. They're all happy that this is true democracy, etc., etc., etc.
Lies nur die Überschriften der Zeitung. Sie sagen alle dasselbe. Demokratie. Sorry, what did you say? Democracy. Also Demokratie ist wieder auf dem Spiel.
This whole voting is this of what we stand on. This is true democracy, etc.
Also es ist wahre Demokratie wieder.
But it's false, right?
Aber es ist falsch.
Okay. America was never born a democracy.
Amerika war nie geboren eine Demokratie.
It was born as a republic.
Es war als eine Republik geboren.
And I posted a little video. It's very nice, this video, how it explains it. Right?
Also ich habe eine kleine Video auf den WhatsApp irgendwie verbreitet in den letzten Tagen und es erklärt es sehr schön.
Now I will simplify it as best I can, right?
Und ich werde versuchen, diesen kleines Video, also so zu verzimplifizieren, so best ich kann.
The only true government by the people for the people is a republic.
Also der einzige wahre Regierungsform von das Volk für das Volk ist eine Republik.
And a republic has laws that control the government.
Und eine Republik hat Regeln in Platz gesetzt, die die Regierung kontrolliert.
Right? And it works perfectly. Pagan Rome, that comes up as a lamb, began as a republic.
Und diese Republik funktioniert perfekterweise. Also heidnisches Rom, der fing an, der friedlich heraufgekommen ist, fing an als eine Republik.
How did it end up?
Und wie ist es am Ende geworden?
A dictatorship, right?
A Diktatur.
Right, so we'll put that down here, right?
So wir werden das hier unten schreiben.
Dictatorship, right?
Diktatur.
And another name for that is an oligarchy.
Und ein anderes Wort dafür, ich weiß nicht, wie das in Deutsch ist, ein Oligarchie.
Right, in the world, name me the types of, in the world, what we see, what's the, basically, what's the two types of dictatorship?
So, in der Welt, sag mir, was sind die zwei Arten von Diktatur, die es gibt?
Communism and fascism, right?
Kommunistisches und faschistisches.
So, communism and fascism, right?
So, Kommunismus und Faschismus.
So, how do we get from here to here?
So, wie kommen wir von einer Republik zu einer Diktatur?
Well, history shows us.
Die Geschichte lehrt uns dies.
How did pagan Rome go from being a republic that was the most powerful nation on the earth, like when it was a republic?
So, wie ist heidnische Rom von das mächtigste Nation der Welt, als es eine Republik war?
What did they do?
So, was taten sie?
They became a democracy.
Sie sind eine Demokratie geworden.
Democracy doesn't work.
So, Demokratie funktioniert nicht.
It's just a middleman from the point of getting from... It's just basically a transition point to get you to one of these. Right?
Also, Demokratie ist nur ein Übergangsform oder einen Mittelmann, der nimmt dich von einer Republik zu einer von diesen zwei.
So, Trump, right? We can see he's a fascist, right?
So Trump, wir können klar sehen, dass er ein Faschist ist.
However,
nichtsdestotrotz,
he's upholding many of these points.
Er hält viele von diesen republikanischen Werte hoch.
What's the other party called?
Wie nennt sich der andere Partei? Democrats.
The Democrats, right?
Demokraten.
Okay, so they want to get, they're here, right? And they want to get to here.
Also, die befinden sich hier und sie wollen sich hierhin bewegen.
Okay. And Trump wants to get down here.
Und Trump aber, der will hier hinkommen.
But he's disguising himself as this, right?
Aber er vertarnt sich als eine Republik.
Okay, so this is what you have to understand, right? And then it's very simple to see.
Also wenn du dies verstehst, dann ist das Politik sehr einfach zu verstehen.
So what you basically have is you have, when the Sunday laws made, the republicanism that comes up here disappears here, right?
Also was wir verstehen ist, wenn der Gesetz gemacht wird, der Republikanismus, der hier heraufkommt, verschwindet hier.
So some point from the time that it comes up here like a lamb, it must transition into a democracy.
So von dem Punkt, wo es hier wie ein Lamm aufkommt, irgendwo hier entlang, es muss übergehen zu einer Demokratie.
To become an oligarchy, right?
Um ein Diktatur oder Oligarchie hier zu werden.
And that's what history shows us. Pagan Rome started off as like this lamb and was this mighty nation and it became an oppressor, it became a dictatorship.
Und das ist, was die Geschichte uns zeigt, dass heidnische Rom fing wie ein Lamm an und würde zu diesen mächtigsten Nationen unter einer Republik, aber würde zu einer grausamen Unterdrücker werden.
Okay.
Diktatur.
So, which two powers brought down Rome?
So, welche zwei Mächten haben Rom zur Fall gebracht?
The Barbarians.
Also die Barbaren.
Islam.
Und Islam.
Right?
Amen.
Okay, that's what history shows. So it's going to show us we should see the exact same things happening, right?
So das zeigt uns die Geschichte und deswegen sollten wir genau dasselbe sich wiederholen.
So I want to suggest this Greek corn represents democracy.
Also ich möchte vorschlagen, dass dieses griechische Horn stellt der Demokratie dar.
And it's just basically, they're just deceiving the people.
Und im Grunde, sie verführen das Volk.
They're making out to be this democratic power, but really, they're communists and they're just waiting to put their jumper on, right?
Sie geben sich so, als wären sie diesen großen Demokratie, aber im Grunde diesen Kommunisten, und sie warten nur, sag einfach mal, deren T-Shirt zu wechseln.
Okay. Okay, so, go back to Daniel 8.
So, zurück zu Daniel 8.
Vers 8.
Und Vers 8.
So, this northern power, this ram, comes up here.
So, diesen Nordkraft, diesen Widder, kommt hier herauf.
And he runs all the way through to the end.
Und right? Er geht den ganzen Weg hindurch bis zur Ende.
Because the prediction here is about its fall.
Denn die Vorhersage hier ist eine Vorhersage über sein Sturz.
And as we read, one of the powers that's going to come against it is the barbarians, the nations.
Und so, wie wir gesehen haben, wie wir gelesen haben, ist, dass eine von den Mächten, die gegen ihn kommen werden, ist die Barbaren, die Nationen.
And that's what we see here in verse 8.
Und das ist das, was wir hier in Daniel 8, Vers 8 sehen.
Therefore the he-goat waxed very great, and when he was strong, the great horn was broken, and for it came up four notable ones towards the four winds of heaven. Right? So we know that this is, or we understand that it's speaking about this league that's made right here.
So wir verstehen, dass es handelt sich über diesen Bündnis, die hier gemacht wird.
Okay. This worldwide league that comes together.
Also weltweites Bündnis, die sich hier zusammenschließen wird.
Because out of one of them comes pagan Rome, right?
Denn aus einer von diesen kommt heidnisches Rom hervor.
Right? Okay. Right, and that's where we're going next, verse 9.
Und da gehen wir jetzt hin, Vers 9.
And out of one of them came forth a little horn, right here.
So, und aus einer von ihnen kam diesen kleinen Horn hervor.
Which waxed exceeding great towards the south, the east, and towards the pleasant land, right? So, how many areas?
So, wie viele Richtungen oder Gegenden?
Three, right? How many did it, this two-horned power do here?
So, wie viele Richtungen diese zwei Hörner gemacht hier?
Three, right?
Auch drei.
So, it's just going to repeat the same thing.
So, es wird dasselbe hier wiederholen.
Okay. It says, verse 10.
Vers 10.
And it waxed great, even to the host of heaven, and it cast down some of the host of the stars to the ground and stamped upon them. What was that a fulfillment of?
So, was ist hier in Erfüllung gegangen?
When did he wax great against the prince of the host?
Warum ist er groß gegen der Prinz des Heer?
The cross, right?
Gekommen. Also das Kreuz.
Ah, okay. So, excuse me. Yes. You're right. Yes. Mm-hmm. Right. So cast down some of the host. The stars are going to stamp upon him. He magnified himself even to the prince of the host, and by him the daily was taken away, and the place of his sanctuary was cast down. Right. So
that's it.
You've got all these different things happening here. You've got
also viele verschiedene Sachen, die hier in diesen Versen geschehen.
You got the cross,
das Kreuz.
You got the daily being taken
das
away.
Das tägliche hinweggenommen.
And you've got the host of heaven being cast, the stars fallen from heaven.
Right? Die Sterne, also den Herr vom Himmel, die niedergefallen werden.
Okay. And in verse 12 it says, our host was given him against the daily by reason of transgression. He cast down the truth to the ground, and it practiced and it prospered.
Vers 12.
So we've been through this, right? The daily is taken away here.
Also das tägliche wird hier weggenommen.
Okay. In Daniel 7, what's plucked up here?
So in Daniel 7, was wird hier ausgerissen?
Three horns.
Drei
one,
Hörner.
Two, three, right?
Eins, zwei und drei.
Daily is taken away.
Das tägliche ist weg.
Okay. And the man of sin is revealed.
Der Mensch der Sünde wird geoffenbart.
In fact, just let's go to 2 Thessalonians.
So lasst uns zur 2. Thessaloniker gehen jetzt.
Because this 2 Thessalonians here is where William Miller understood the taking away, the daily.
So right? Here, 2. Thessalonicher, das ist der Bibelstelle, wo William Miller verstanden hat, das Wegnehmen des täglichen.
Right? And these verses are directly linked to Daniel chapter 8. Right?
Diese Versen sind in direkter Verbindung mit Daniel Kapitel 8.
So it says, verse 3.
Vers 3.
Let no man deceive you by any means, for that day shall not come except there come a falling away first. That's these stars,
diese Sterne,
falling from heaven.
Die vom Himmel fallen.
The man of sin be revealed. That's the papacy.
So der Papsttum ist der Mensch der Sünden, der offenbart wird.
The son of perdition, who opposeth and exalteth himself above all that is called God, or that is worshipped, so that he is God, sitteth in the temple of God, showing himself that he is God. Remember ye not that when I was yet with you, I told you these things? And now ye know what withholdeth, that he might be revealed in his time. For the mystery of iniquity doth already work. Only he who now letteth will let, until he be taken out of the way. And then shall that wicked be revealed, whom the Lord shall consume with the spirit of his mouth, and shall destroy with the brightness of his coming. Even him whose coming is after the working of Satan with all power and signs and lying wonder. Right? So, when the daily pagan Rome is taken away, right, the man of sin rules.
Also wenn das tägliche heidnische Rom weggenommen ist, der Mensch der Sünde regiert.
And we're talking about them giving up their religion and they become under the woman, right?
Das heißt, sie geben ihre Religion auf und sie stellen sich unter der Frau.
And that's this two-horned pup, right?
Und das ist denn hier diese zweihörnige Macht.
Okay, and that's what we were just reading about. That history there from Daniel 8, 9 to 12 is the history of pagan and papal Rome, these two horns.
Diese Geschichte von Daniel 8, 9 bis 12, das ist die Geschichte von heidnischer und päpstliches Rom, diese zwei Hörner.
Amen.
Amen.
Okay, now go to Daniel 8 and verse 13.
Jetzt Daniel 8, Vers 13.
So, Daniel's at a point now where he's seen this vision, right?
Daniel ist jetzt an einem Punkt angekommen, wo er diese Vision gesehen hat.
It says, then I heard one saint speaking, and another saint said unto that certain saint which spake, how long shall be the vision concerning the daily and the transgression of desolation, to give both the sanction and the host to be trodden under foot? And he said unto me, unto 2,300 days, then shall the sanctuary be cleansed. And it came to pass, when I, Daniel, had seen the vision and sought for the meaning, then behold, there stood before me the appearance of a man. Where is Daniel?
So wo ist Daniel jetzt? Vers 15 haben wir gelesen.
Where's Daniel on the line?
Wo ist Daniel auf der Linie?
The beginning of the 10, right?
Also am Anfang des 10.
Because he's getting this vision now, he's appearing before him. And what does he see?
Also er erhält diese Vision und er erscheint vor ihm jetzt. Und was sieht er?
He sees Christ.
Er sieht Christus.
And these two angels.
Und diese zwei Engel.
What did he see when Abraham lifted up his eyes? What did Abraham see?
Was hat Abraham gesehen, als er seine Augen emporgehoben hat?
Christ and two angels.
Christus und zwei Engel.
Okay, and in Daniel chapter 7, it says he asked one of the angels that stood by. Right?
Und in Daniel 7, es sagt, er befragte eine von den Engeln, die daneben stand.
Okay, so it says, and it came to pass, when I, even I, Daniel, seen the vision and sought for meaning, then behold, there stood before me the appearance of a man. And I heard a man's voice between the banks of the Ulai, which called and said, Gabriel, make this man to understand the vision. So it marks this point where he's been given an understanding of the vision.
So right? Markiert der Punkt, wo eine Verständnis über diese Vision gegeben wird.
So he came near where I stood, and when he came, I was afraid and fell upon my face. But he said unto me, understand, O son of man, for at the time of the end shall be the vision. Now as he was speaking with me, I was in a deep sleep upon my face toward the ground, and he touched me and set me upright. Okay? So in Daniel chapter 9, when does he touch him?
So in Daniel 9, wann berührte er ihn?
We went through this other day.
Wir haben das vorherige
Tag. At the ninth hour, right?
An der neunte Stunde.
Okay? All marking this point.
Right? Alles markiert genau diesen Punkt hier.
So what's he going to do to him right now?
So was werde er mit ihm tun hier und jetzt?
In Daniel chapter 7, what did the angel come and do für Daniel.
In Daniel 7, was hat der Engel für ihn getan?
He explained him the vision. How did he speak to him?
Er erklärte ihm die Vision. Und wie sprach er mit ihm?
Clearly, right?
So im Klartext.
He just told him exactly what everything meant, right?
So er sagte ihm klar heraus, was alles bedeutete.
So he touches him and sets him upright.
So er rührte ihm an und setzte ihm auf.
And he said, behold, I will make thee know what shall be in the last end of the indignation, for the time appointed the end shall be. And now he speaks to him plainly.
So here, verse 19, and er spricht mit ihm klar.
The ram which thou sawest having two horns are the kings of Media and Persia. So he's telling him plainly.
So er sagt ihm im Klartext jetzt.
Why must the Lord tell us everything plainly here?
So warum muss der Herr uns hier alles im Klartext erklären? Because we need to speak Klartext to the kings.
Yes, because everything that we are proclaiming here has to be so clear even a child can understand it.
Right? Alles, was wir hier voraussagen, muss so klar sein, dass selbst ein Kind es verstehen kann.
Okay. And I would just ask this point, right? If we really believe that we're somewhere in here, are we having that experience?
So, und ich möchte die Frage stellen, wenn wir wirklich glauben, dass wir irgendwo hier drinnen sind, haben wir jetzt diese Erfahrung?
Yes. What I'm saying is, do we see things much more clearly, much more plainly?
Also die Frage ist, sehen wir Sachen viel klarer? Ist es deutlicher für uns?
I can't speak for everybody else, but for me, my eyes are being opened to many things. It's wonderful.
Also ich kann nicht für jeder hier sprechen, aber meine Augen werden für viele Sachen geöffnet und es ist wunderbar.
Okay, so it says, and the rough goat is the king of Grecia, and the great horn that is between his eyes is the first king. Now that being broken, whereas four stood up for it, four kingdoms shall stand out of the nation, but not in his power. And in the latter time of their kingdom, when the transgressors are come to the full, a king of fierce countenance and understanding dark sentence shall stand up. And his power shall be mighty, but not by his own power. And he shall destroy wonderfully, and shall prosper and practice, and shall destroy the mighty and the holy people. And through his policy also he shall cause craft to prosper in his hand, and he shall magnify himself in his heart, and by peace shall destroy many. He shall also stand up against the prince of princes, but he shall be broken without hand. And the vision of the evening and the morning which was told is true. Wherefore shut thou up the vision, for it shall be for many days. So he says, he told him, he asked him the question, how long? And the answer was 2,300 evenings and mornings.
Right? Einer stellte die Frage, wie lange? Und es wird ihm gesagt, für 2,300 Abende und Morgen.
Then shall the sanctuary be cleansed.
Dann würde das Heiligtum gereinigt werden.
And we are that sanctuary, right?
Und wir sind dieser Heiligtum.
And we know that Christ in the Sunday law from stick with the Sunday law, from temple cleansing to temple cleansing was this work of cleansing us, right?
Wir wissen, dass Christus in das Sonntagsgesetz von Tempelreinigung bis zur Tempelreinigung ist das Werk, uns zu reinigen.
And it's just another symbol of the same work.
Es ist eine andere Darstellung, dasselbe Werk.
So, we can see how all these chapters, right, they're all speaking about the same thing and they're all bringing us to this point, right? In our case, we're at this point, right?
So, wir können sehen, dass all diese Kapiteln, die sprechen alle über dasselbe und die bringen uns allen zu diesem Punkt. Und in unserem Fall, wir sind an diesem Punkt gerade.
Because this here is like a foreshadow of this,
denn
right?
Das hier ist eine Schatte von dies hier,
right?
Amen.
But you can see here in the book of Daniel, all the focus is down at this one.
Aber wir können sehen, dass das Buch Daniel das ganze Augenmerk weist auf diesen Punkt hier hin.
But we can see in Daniel 8, right, you have this, what happens here just gets repeated here.
Aber wir können sehen in Daniel 8, dass das, was hier geschieht, wiederholt sich eben hier.
Okay, confirming right here, there's going to be a punishment. And that's where we're about to experience this punishment right here.
Und das bestätigt, dass hier eine Bestrafung ist. Und das ist das, was wir kurz bevorstehen, dass wir diese Bestrafung zu sehen bekommen werden.
Amen.
Amen.
So, like I said, I can't speak for everybody else, but I have lots of things running around inside my head that I want to understand.
Right? Also ich kann nicht für jeder andere sprechen, wie ich bereits gesagt habe, aber ich habe vieles, der in meinem Kopf hin und her geht, die ich verstehen möchte.
Okay, and I'm sure that the Lord will help us to understand everything that we need to know at this time.
Und ich bin mir sicher, dass der Herr wird uns helfen, alles zu verstehen, was wir gerade in dieser Zeit verstehen müssen.
Amen.
Amen.
Okay, let's close with prayer and then we will have a short break before we do our question and answer session.
So wir werden mit Gebet schließen und dann werden wir eine kurze Pause machen und dann werden wir unsere Fragen und Antwort Stunde haben.
Dear Heavenly Father,
lieber himmlischer Vater,
Lord, I want to thank you for these wonderful illustrations.
Herr, ich möchte dir danken für diese wunderbare Darstellung.
And I want to pray you forgive me for all the when my mind gets a little confused with all these different symbols.
Und ich möchte, dass du mich vergibst, Herr, wo mein Verstand manchmal konfus wird mit all diese verschiedenen Symbolen.
And I pray that you'll help us to patiently and carefully consider every point.
Und ich bete, dass du uns hilfst, dass wir geduldig jeder Punkt betrachten werden.
And that nobody would take my word for any of this, but they would be true Bereans and searchers for themselves.
Und dass keine meiner Wörter an diese Dinge glauben werden, sondern dass sie wie Berea die Sachen für sich selbst herausforschen.
But I know, Lord, it says, if we search you, we shall find you when we seek you with all our heart.
Aber ich weiß, dass es steht geschrieben, dass wenn wir dich suchen, wir werden dich finden, wenn wir dich suchen mit ganzem Herzen.
So please help us to put our hearts to you now, Lord, and trust that you will really give these things in such a clear way that even, as I said, a child could understand it.
So bitte hilft uns, dass wir unsere Herzen dir zuneigen, Herr, dass, wie ich gesagt habe, dass du diese Dinge uns so offenbarst, dass selbst ein Kind sie verstehen kann.
That when these things come to pass, that your name would be glorified.
So dass, wenn diese Dinge zustande kommen, dass dein Name verherrlicht wird.
So we just want to thank you and ask all this in the name of Jesus.
So wir möchten nur danken und all dies bitten im Namen Jesu.
Amen.
Amen.